Hi guys, in this video essay I'm going to be talking about La Haine, a classic French film dealing with police brutality and systemic violence towards ethnic minorities in France. The film is famous for highlighting the feeling of entrapment and powerlessness of these ethnic groups and the crisis of masculinity that comes out of it. The characters we follow in La Haine are constantly abused and cast aside without the ability to respond or change anything about the world they're living in. This makes them constantly feel powerless, insignificant, and as Vince puts it,
putain, je me sens comme une petite fourmi perdue dans l'univers intergalactique.
It's this sense of existential insignificance that I want to talk about in this essay, particularly Kassovitz's use of cinematic tools like composition and sound design to communicate this without the need for dialogue. The first and most apparent technique he uses is the size and placement of the characters in the frame. Often we see our three characters very small in frame, surrounded by the world they inhabit and constantly in the midst of it. This is a visual cue to reflect how they feel, i.e. very small in a very big world. To reinforce this visual theme of being part of a bigger picture, Kassovitz often includes shots that show many homes or lots of people to remind us that these three characters are just three amongst countless others. If that was too subtle, he makes sure this context is felt by opening the film with a straight up shot of the entire planet. Like, literally the whole planet, just to give us a sense of scale. As well as visual composition to reinforce his feeling of insignificance, Kassovitz also uses sound design. Take for example this scene, where we're introduced to Saeed. The music from the intro sequence fades away into a distant echo and blends with the sounds of the environment, pulling us into his perspective and giving us, you know, a feel of the scale of the atmosphere around him. This technique is used again later in one of the most famous scenes in the film, where the DJ plays out of his window into the estate. As he plays his music, the camera moves across window after window and then more and more different groups of people, from an eye of God type perspective, really to hit home just how many people are in this area. And if that wasn't enough, as the camera moves up, the music becomes more distant and echoed to really give us a sense of scale, until finally, we are confronted with a seemingly endless plane of more and more buildings. This one shot highlights the inconceivable scale of the environment our characters are inhabiting. This theme of placing our characters amid a massive and bustling world is no better displayed than in this following shot, which I'm just going to shut up and let you watch. I mean, like, holy shit, look at that shot. In one elegant move, we go from a wide shot of a bustling city filled with people and activity, straight into a focused, personal shot singling out our three main characters. He literally picked out our three needles in this massive haystack of people in one camera move. Also, shout out to camera op and focus puller, because that must have been a bitch to pull off. Before I finish this essay, I just want to talk about one last little scene that I think is particularly touching, and that's this one. Because although our characters feel like they are nothing, and yes, at this particular moment in time, they didn't click at the right time, amid all of those lights in that expanse of the Paris skyline, someone, somewhere, clicked at the right time. Although there are many things that make La Haine awesome, I really wanted to talk about this aspect of it because it's really impressive how Kassovitz used the visual and auditory tools of cinema to communicate something as complicated as existential insignificance. It really is an excellent example of genius filmmaking, and I really wanted to break it down and share it with you guys. I hope it was interesting, I hope it was informative, I hope it helped in some way or form if you're a filmmaker, or if you're a film lover, I hope it was just, you know, a good way of killing a few minutes. Either way, I'm going to be making more of these, so if you want to see more breakdowns and more video essays, you can go watch my old one that I did on Dawn of the Planet of the Apes, or you can stay tuned for my next ones coming up. Probably be This is England or Jaws. Either way, stay tuned to the next one. Till then, thanks for watching. Peace.